Let's have a short and crisp AI coffee break because we really need to talk about a paper that presents an idea so simple yet so effective that it made me say, why did I not think about this? Well, of course, the power of hindsight is never to be underestimated. The paper in question is this one, presenting the REPA loss term for diffusion models which can make better diffusion transformers because they learn more general purpose image representations and it speeds up their training by letting them borrow wisdom from a pre-trained model like Dino V2. It's like diffusion models are asking, can I copy your homework? And honestly, the results are incredible, so let's get started. First, let's understand the problem. Diffusion models are neural nets trained to generate images from noise and are incredibly powerful at it. Just think of Stable Diffusion, DALL-E, Midjourney, or any other diffusion model you might use these days. They've produced some of the most realistic AI-generated visuals we've ever seen. But here's the catch. Their visual representations often lack the abstractions needed for tasks other than image generation, like classifying images or identifying objects. It's not like diffusion models' representations are unusable for these tasks, but they're definitely not great. Especially since we know that there are self-supervised models that are much, much better at these tasks. Think of VIT or Dino, for example. This is because diffusion models are trained to reconstruct noisy images into clean ones. This process retains all the unnecessary details required for reconstruction, but doesn't focus on abstract features like whether an image is a cat or a dog. Models like Dino V2, on the other hand, are trained with an entirely different objective. They're using contrastive self-supervised learning where the task is to take different zoomings or croppings or rotations or other image manipulations and learn to represent them the same. By learning with this objective, they excel at understanding abstract features by focusing on high-level concepts. They have no other choice because the pixel-level details are different between the different croppings anyway. The big idea in this paper is simple yet brilliant. Why not let diffusion models learn from models like Dino V2 that already have strong abstract representations? This happens simply through a regularization loss term which is added to the reconstruction loss of diffusion models. This new loss term forces the diffusion model to align its representations with the pre-trained abstractions of Dino V2, and this alignment not only accelerates training, but also makes diffusion models better at capturing these general-purpose visual representations. It's like giving diffusion models a shortcut to learn faster and smarter by copying the knowledge of a model that has better representations. So here's how it works in more detail. The authors take existing transformer-based diffusion models like DIT and SIT and train them with REPA on ImageNet at a resolution of 256x256 pixels. These diffusion models have a latent diffusion model architecture, so the diffusion model does not work with the images directly, but with smaller tensors of dimension 32x32x4 as encoded by the Stable Diffusion's VAE. For the first 8 layers of the diffusion model's transformer, the authors extracted the outputs of these layers and passed them through a trainable MLP network. Then, with the REPA loss term, they maximized the cosine similarity between the outputs of this MLP and the final image representations of Dino V2. To sum it up, the diffusion model trained as usual to generate images with the reconstruction loss term, ensuring that it's still able to reconstruct images, but now the additional REPA loss term helps diffusion models align their internal understandings of images with the abstract representations of Dino V2. The results on image generation are striking. For SIT, REPA reduced training time dramatically. The model now learns faster and better to reconstruct images by reaching an FID of 7.9 after just 400,000 training steps. FID measures how similar generated images are to real images, where lower is better. And compare that to the vanilla SIT model, which only managed an FID of 8.3 after 400,000 training steps. So with REPA, SIT reached a better FID score 17.5 times faster. For DIT, REPA brought the FID down from 19.5 to 12.3 after 400,000 training steps. And REPA also improved tasks other than image generation. The linear probing accuracy of SIT on ImageNet image classification jumped from the blue line, which is SIT without REPA, to the red line, which is SIT with REPA. It closes the gap to Dino V2, which is the black dotted line. And remember that REPA regularization was applied until layer 8 only, so it is at layer 8 where we expect image classification performance to peak, because it copies the representations of Dino V2 only until layer 8. Representations which are good at image classification, but after layer 8, it focuses again on image generation. So as mentioned earlier in this video, diffusion models were not too bad before at image classification. I mean, 52% is much above the random baseline, but not great either. Now with REPA, this score is at a presentable 72%. So this isn't just faster learning, it's smarter learning. So what do you think about this paper? Can this alignment of diffusion model training to the visual representations of other models be a long-term approach? Or is it just a crutch until diffusion models will get better by themselves? At what point might the limitations of a system like Dino V2 become a bottleneck for the diffusion model? Or maybe it is just the first step towards having a model train end-to-end on the diffusion model image generation objective and on the contrastive learning objective of Dino-like models. What are your thoughts on this? Let me know in the comments below. So in any case, that's it for today's AI coffee break. As always, if you enjoyed this paper breakdown, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. See you next time!